بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أناديه ويستر علي كل عورة وأنا أعصيه، ويعظم النعمة علي فلا أجازيه. نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة، وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا، حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر، تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر، سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. صدق الله العلي العظيم. I would like to share 3 points with you tonight on this most blessed night during the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is the most blessed month, and the night of Qadr is the most blessed night of the entire month. A night with sublimity and superiority. Laylatul Qadri khayrun min alf shahr, superior to 1,000 months. It's a very special night, very special hours and very special minutes, and we have to make use of every second of this night before dawn. 3 points I'd like to share with you. Point number one is that tonight Allah furnished this night for us and presented this night for an important reason. And that reason is to reconnect with Him. The night of istighfar, the night of repentance, the night where we go back to our Lord. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. If they ask about me, I am very eminent, I am close to them, I respond to the prayers, I respond to the call of the callers. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي, let them respond to me. وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي, let them trust me. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ, they might be guided to the straight path. So tonight is the night where we go back to Allah. Throughout the year, throughout the months, the weeks, the days, we have committed sins. And no one is immune from sins. We all committed sins. Some of these sins are minor, some of them are very grave and gross and major and cardinal sins. But Allah, through His mercy, through His compassion, كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ, He is determined to accept us, to embrace us, provided that we have the will to go back to Him. We must have the will. We have to initiate this step of going back to Him. He is waiting for us to receive us, to embrace us, to admit us into His mercy and forgiveness and His paradise. But He says, you have to have the will. You have to be serious about this. كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ, أنه من عمل منكم سوءا بجهالة عمل منكم سوءا. وإذا جاءك الذين يؤمنون بآياتنا, say to those who trust God, those who do not trust God, this verse is not addressing them. This verse is addressing those in Surah Al-An'am, those who have a trust and have faith in God. وَإِذَا جَاءَكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا, those who trust in my signs, say to them, فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ, receive them with peace. Be warm in your reception. فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِ الرَّحْمَةِ, he has ordained, he has an obligation, God, which is free from all obligations. Here he says, I have an obligation. I gave my word. I gave my promise. كتب ربكم على نفسه الرحمة. He has ordained upon him the mercy, the forgiveness. أنه for those. رحمة for whom? For those. أنه من عمل منكم سوءا بجهالة ثم تاب من بعده. If someone does a sin, commits a sin out of ignorance, out of forgetfulness, غفلة, إجهالة, غفلة. He's not defying God. His intention is not to defy God. But he forgot and we forget. We're humans. This is part of our nature. Sometimes we surrender to our desires. God says, if this is the case, you have committed a sin, ثم تاب من بعده, he decides to repent. وأصلح. Why the أصلح? The أصلح you have to fix, because sin damages many things. Sins damages your soul first, your nafs. It gets hurt. The nafs gets hurt. Sin is like a heart attack. A heart attack will do some damage to the heart of the patient. The same thing with the sin. Sin does damage to the nafs, to the soul, to the real heart, spiritual heart of the patient, of the sinner. Therefore, you have to fix it. Sometimes this sin against yourself, sometimes it's against others. You have to fix the damage you did to others. وَأَصْلَحْ فَإِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. The hadith says, Tawbah has four steps. And all these four steps, they begin with R in English. They all begin with R. Number one, it is remorse, nadam, nadamun bilqalb. The first step to go back to Allah tonight, the night of Qadr. This night is a gift. This night is a bonus. It's a bonus from God. God is waiting there for you. God is expediting your case. God today has an open house. You see some properties that they want to sell? They have an open house. You don't have to get an appointment. Walk in. You just walk. You walk and see the property. You don't have to call the agent. God today has an open house. But for what? He's not selling property. He's selling mercy. He's extending his compassion and his forgiveness and his afu, his maghfirah, and his mercy to us. Tonight is a bonus night. Don't miss tonight. But it has four steps. We have to follow the order. The steps is number one, nadamun bilqalb. Four R's. R number one, nadam, remorse. We must feel the pain of what we did. We must admit that we committed a sin. The problem with so many people who do not seek forgiveness is that because they are reluctant to admit that they committed a sin. Shaytan tells them, no, don't confess. Don't even think that you committed a sin. You did nothing. You did nothing wrong. But we have to admit. We have to fight Satan and his temptations. So number one is to admit remorse, nadamun bilqalb. If your heart is broken, it means that you passed the first step successfully. The second step, استغفار باللسان. The second R, remember, the first R was remorse, the second R is repentance. You have to repent tonight. Part of the a'mal of tonight and the du'as that we do is to say استغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه as much as you can. As much as you can. So you have to say that. You have to say it. You have to admit verbally. Make a verbal commitment. Make a verbal confession. Astaghfirullah. I seek forgiveness from God. This is number two. The third step into forgiveness is amalun bil jawarih. The third R is recovery. Amalun bil jawarih. Now, sometimes we say astaghfirullah with the tongue, but there is a further step, is that you have to restore, restoration with your limbs, with your hands. With the hand, we committed many sins with the hand. With the same hand, you have to do good things. You have to pay charity with the hand. You have to help your parents with your hand. You have to help someone in the street, cross the street. This is an act of charity. You have to bring a smile to people. You have to give food with your hand, with your eyes, with your tongue, with your ears. You have to do good. Say good. As we said bad to people, we insulted people, we have to say good to people. وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. So this is the third step of istighfar. Recovery. عَمَلٌ بِالْجَوَارِحِ. And the fourth step, the final one, is the fourth R, which is resolve not to go back to sin. وَعَزْمٌ عَلَىٰ أَنْ لَا يَعُودْ. عَزْم means resolve. You make a commitment that this time that I committed a sin and I'm seeking forgiveness from God, that time was the final time, the last time. I'm not going to go back to this sin. But if you cannot make this resolve, and you say astaghfirullah, but deep inside your heart, you say, well, if this opportunity comes again of sinning, I will do it again. Because Allah has another Laylatul Qadr next year. I'm going to come to IECOC. Again, we eat Afghani food, and then we listen to Sayyid Mustafa, and then we seek forgiveness. This is not a resolve. You are cheating here. And Allah says, I would not accept that from you. Resolve is to make a strong commitment that I'm not going to go back. Who knows whether I'm going to be alive tomorrow? Who knows we are going to stay alive until the end of this month, the month of Ramadan? There is no guarantee. There is no guarantee. So we have to seize this opportunity tonight. Remember, four R's. R number one, remorse. Second, repentance. Third, recovery. And fourth, four is what? Resolve not to do this sin again. These steps were presented by Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wasalam. What is the most important thing in this universe? The most important thing in this universe is you. And what is the most important thing inside you? The most important thing inside you is your nafs. And what is the most important thing inside your nafs? What is it? The most important thing inside your nafs is God. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا تسعني أرضي وسمائي وإنما يسعني قلب عبدي المؤمن. He has decided to dwell inside your nafs, inside your heart. So take care of this precious tenant that you have. Tenant you have inside you. Who decided to live in your heart, in your nafs. And don't break the relationship with him. Don't hurt him. Because if you lose this tenant, you are not going to find someone better than him. You are going to lose forever. So try not to lose him. Try to keep him in your heart. You need God. A day will come that no father, no mother, no husband, no wife, no neighbor, no brother, no friend, no governor, no president can help you or serve you. They all become disabled. There is only one who can be with you. And if you have that one, you don't need anyone else. And that one is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go back to Allah. Allah is waiting for your arrival. Allah is waiting for you just to say, Ya Allah, no more. It's true, Ya Allah, true, that comes from your heart, not just your tongue. Ya Allah, I'm coming back to you. I have nowhere to go. I'm desperate to come back to you because you are the only one who can answer me. وَلْيَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Do not be despondent. Do not be despaired. Never say that I've been praying for so many weeks and so many months, but he did not respond to me. Never say that. Never be despaired. Keep knocking at his door until he opens the door for you. And this is exactly what he says. He says, the hadith says, مَنْ أَكْثَرَ قَرْعَ الْبَابِ يُفْتَحُ لَهُ. If you keep knocking at the door, at the end, they will open the door for you. God will open it for you because God knows you are sincere. The reason sometimes he does not open the door because we are not sincere. He does not open the door. The day he feels God knows about yourself, that tonight you are sincere, he will open it for you. So this is number one. Tonight is the night of istighfar, my friends. The night of tawbah. When you pray tahajjud tonight, which consists of 11 units, salatul layl, 11 rak'ah. At the last rak'ah, salatul watr. Wal-shaf'i wal-watr. Salatul watr is singular, one rak'ah. When you raise your hand, remember your family members. Remember your parents. Begin with your parents. Begin with your family. Begin with those who raised you, nurtured you, fed you, supported you. Remember those who have favor upon you, those who taught you. Remember them. Remember your extended family. Remember your friends. And then pray for yourself. Az-Zahra alayha salam, Lady Fatima alayha salam, she would stand in her sanctuary in communion, tahajjud with her Lord. Her son Imam Hassan says, I was little watching my mother doing Salatul Layl, and she keeps mentioning the names of her friends, the neighbors, people in the community, but she does not mention her name. I said to her, Ya Ummah, why don't you say me? My mother would say, Bunayya, al-jaru qabla al-dar. First, we have to begin with neighbors. This is the tradition of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Musa alayhi salam said, one day said, Ilahi, how do you want me to shout, to scream, to yell so you can hear me? Allah said to him, you don't have to scream. I can hear you. He said, but sometimes you don't hear me. Allah said to him, if you want me to hear you, ادعني على لسان غيرك. Ask others to pray for me. Ask people to pray for me. I will hear. I will listen and I will respond. So pray for others and let others pray for you. And once you pray for others, you're going to increase the love and the respect with others. Believe me, if you don't like someone, and if you are finding ways to go back to that person, pray for them, and you will see that you're going to like them after that. Try to force yourself to pray for others. Prayers for others is one of the ways of reconnecting people with each other. Building the bridges, broken bridges, rebuilding these bridges of a humanity. So this is number one. Number two, my friends, tonight, so tonight is the night of istighfar. And the second point that I want to mention is that tonight you have to ask Allah without hesitation and ask Him for everything, the smallest to the largest. Ask Him for everything. Tonight, decisive night. Surah Al-Dukhan that we're going to read soon, inshallah, tonight. Hameen والقرآن المبين إنا أنزلناه في ليلة مباركة إنا كنا منذرين فيها. What happened tonight? Why it is مباركة, blessed? Why? فيها يفرق كل أمر حكيم. أمر من عنده. Tonight, every important decision is going to be determined and sealed tonight. But it is not in isolation from you. I mentioned this in previous seasons, that tonight Allah is not going to work without you. He is going to work in partnership with you. How is that? I mentioned part of it last night. Allah says tonight, it is true that Allah predestines. Allah predestines for us. And pre-plans for us, but not in isolation from us, in partnership with us. This is why tonight He says, I want you to work hard. I want you to ask Me. I want you to petition. I want you to insist on Me. Tonight I want you to seek forgiveness. Tonight I want you to do good. I want you to help. Tonight I want you to determine in your heart, each and every in your heart, between you and God, that if Allah helps me, I'll be a better son to my parents. I will be a better husband to my wife. I'll be a better father to my kids. I'll be a better wife to my husband, a better mother for my kids. I'll be a better neighbor. Maybe in the past I did not do good to my neighbors. From now on I will do good. Maybe with my extended family member, I neglected them in the past. But from now on, after this night, I'll try to reach out to members of my family. I try to reach out for the poor people, for the needy, for the sick, for the orphans. I'll try to do better. I work on myself. Make this intention between you and God. Niyyah. Niyyatul mar'i khayrun min amalih. Sometimes your intention is better than your work. So in partnership with you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting for you to hear these words from you, that you're going to change yourself. Say, God, maybe in the past I abused myself. I did bad things in my life to myself and to my family. From now on, I'm going to stop. I'm not going to repeat these things. I'm going to come back to you. So in partnership with Allah, with the Lord, He's deciding our fate from now, tonight, until next year. And it will affect our livelihood, risk, which is sustenance. It would also affect, definitely, it would affect our lifespan. Lifespan is dependent tonight. It's determined tonight. Allah will decide how long I'm going to live. So this is the second. The second thing we do tonight, ask. وَاسْأَلُ اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ وَاسْأَلُ اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. When it comes to people, don't ask people. Control yourself. Even at the time of need, try not to ask people for help. But when it comes to God, we have to do the opposite. We have to keep asking. وَاسْأَلُ اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِكُمْ رَحِيمًا. Ask Him tonight. Not only for yourself. Ask for others, please. Today, the Muslim Ummah, Muslim countries are bleeding in a state of hemorrhage. Muslim Ummah, every single country is bleeding today. Because of the fitna, because of civil wars, because of this sectarianism. Look at the map of the Muslim countries and tell me what country is very safe. We have to pray for Islam. We have to pray for Muslimin, for the Mu'mineen. We have to pray for the oppressed people of Yemen. We are waiting for your dua tonight. Pray for the oppressed people in Syria, in Iraq, in Egypt, in Tunisia, in Algeria, in Iran, in Pakistan, in Afghanistan, in Africa, in other countries, in Palestine. Pray for the Mu'mineen in the Arabian Peninsula. Pray for the Mu'mineen in Bahrain, in the Gulf states. Pray for them. Muslims are bleeding today. We have to go back to Allah. Part of why we have ISIS dominating some parts is because we turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَتْرُكُ الْأَمْرَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ Amir al-Mu'mineen says, Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salatu wa sallam, وَلَا تَتْرُكُ الْأَمْرَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَالنَّهِي عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ فَيُوَلَّى عَلَيْكُمْ شِرَارُكُمْ ثُمَّ يَدْعُوا خِيَارُكُمْ فَلَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ Do not shun away from the responsibility of enjoining good and forbidding evil. Don't do that. Once you do that, if you don't enjoy good, if you don't forbid evil, فَيُوَلَّى عَلَيْكُمْ شِرَارُكُمْ The evil ones are going to get control of you. Who are more evil, tell me, who are more evil today than ISIS? Now ISIS are in control, and they are expanding. They are expanding day after day. فَيُوَلَّى عَلَيْكُمْ شِرَارُكُمْ Those evil ones are going to be your leaders. Your caliphs, they impose their leadership upon you, whether you like it or not. ثُمَّ يَدْعُوا خِيَارُكُمْ Even though the righteous are going to say, Oh Allah, فَلَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُمْ It would not be listened. The dua would be rejected. Because you did not do good. You were careless. You were careless. That's the result of what you do. إِنَّمَا تُجْزَوْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ So, let's live up to this responsibility. Let's pray for others and let's do good. And the third point that I want to mention tonight, and I conclude with this point. Tonight, my friends, there is a heavy traffic, but we don't see it with our eyes. There is a heavy traffic of, and it's mentioned in Surah, Inna anzalna fi laylatul qadr, wa ma adraka ma laylatul qadr. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح. Tonight the angels are commuting between the earth and heaven. Between the earth and heaven. Very heavy traffic of angels. Why they come down to the earth? Why? They come down here for a reason which is also mentioned in the Quran. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها during ليلة القدر فيها بإذن ربهم with the leave of their Lord من كل أمر They bring every important issue. They bring it to whom? Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says Since the creation of this earth Allah created Laylatul Qadr And since the creation of man on earth, the angels, they started commuting between heaven and earth, up and down, during this night, until Fajr. Salamun hiya hatta matla'i Fajr. They bring the a'mal and the fate, the destiny of the creatures, the people, and they show them to that leader who's on earth. One day the leader was Adam, they were showing the a'mal to him. One day after Adam came Noah, after that many other prophets, after that Musa, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, after that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahumma sallam And after the prophet, the imams, the disciples of the prophets, the rightful successors of the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, beginning with Imam Ali alayhi salam, and now guess. When they come here, who they visit on earth? They visit the 12th Imam, Al-Imam Al-Mahdi Al-Muntazar عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف. So my friends, you have to renew your allegiance with this Imam, your bay'ah with this Imam. This Imam is not a fake Imam, it's not like Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, a mass murderer who appoints himself as a caliph, successor to the Prophet. Someone who did all sorts of wicked crimes, fornication, drinking, stealing, theft, murder, Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. And now he's the caliph. And some people, believe me, some Muslims, they deserve a caliph like Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. They deserve it. Good for them. When people refuse truth, when they refuse justice, when they refuse the right path, Allah says, okay, don't worry, take care of yourself. Let someone else take care of you. Enjoy Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. But we are the followers of the truth. And we are the followers of Ahlul Bayt. We are the followers of the people that God said about them in the Holy Quran, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهِ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. And therefore, we have leadership. We don't want someone to declare himself an imam or leader for us. Allah has appointed those leaders. Allah says in the Holy Quran, this is my job. مَا كَانَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. My job is to introduce prophets and messengers and also imams. Also imams. I was listening to the Mufti of Egypt. I'd love to share this with you. Yesterday, he has a program on TV before Maghrib in Cairo. He says, and these are his words, I don't want to do insult to anyone. I'm just quoting him. He says Sunnis are more democratic than Shias. Because Shias, they believe in following certain people in the family of the Prophet, while the Sunnis, they believe in election, free election. And they had a free election and they elected Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman. Free election, mashallah. Free election. If you read the history, two people nominated Abu Bakr. Two only people. The rest they did not accept him. Two people, one by the name of Umar ibn al-Khattab, the second was Abu Ubaidah ibn al-Jarrah. They sat in Saqifat Bani Sa'ida while the Prophet is not buried yet. They said, we nominate Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr said, no, Umar, you be the Khalifa, Habibi, you are more competent. Umar said, no, you are older than me. So, and Umdud Yadaka Ubay'uk, give me your hand. He stretches his hand. He says, Abu Bakr Khalifa, immediately by Abu Ubaidah. And the rest, they had some of them, they had to follow out of fear. And some of them, they had no choice. This is democracy. This is democracy, Ya Shaykh al-Azhar. This is democracy. I want to tell him from here, this podium, and I hope he will hear me. I want to tell him, you are the highest religious authority in Egypt, Al-Imam al-Akbar, is the Grand Imam. Did people elect you to be the Grand Imam? Did the 60, 70 million Egyptians elected you through open democracy, free democracy? Who elected you? You were appointed by Hosni Mubarak. So if election is good, why then you were not elected? Huh? Some people, they don't use their brain. Allah says, لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. If there is democracy, it is within the school of Ahlul Bayt. Democracy, it means listen to God. Because God is wiser than you. God is more compassionate to you than your own self. Listen to Him. And we did listen to Him. And God says, إِنَّمَا وَلِيُّكُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَهُمْ رَاكِعُونَ. Those are the leaders, and we followed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We followed Allah. We did not put our desire before God. We followed Allah. Therefore, our imam now, we do have an imam, and we are proud of that imam. And our Imam is Al-Hujjah ibn al-Mahdi al-Muntazar عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف. So renew your allegiance to him. And we will recite this dua at the end. Renew your allegiance. Tell him, you are my Imam. Although I can't see you with this physical eye, I can feel you with my heart. And I renew my bay'ah, my allegiance, my loyalty, my fellowship with you. You are the Imam. You are the rightful Imam. But the Imam is going to tell you, in return for this, I'm going to ask you to do me a favor. What is the favor, if you ask the Imam? What is the favor that you want me to do to you? Imam is going to say, Taqwallah, fear God in your life. Taqwallah ta'ala. Be a God-fearing person. If you become a God-fearing person, if you don't submit to others but to God, you're going to live a life, you're going to lead a life of dignity, izzah, a life of karam, a life of honor, a life of qurb, nearness to Allah, a life that even if there's a tragedy in your family, even if something terrible happens to you or to a member of your family, you say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. I accept the will of God. I don't reject it. This is. Allah did not say, those who are a friend of me, nothing will happen to them. No accident, no death, no loss. He never said that. No sickness. He said it will happen to them, but they are not going to lose themselves. Because they have good friendship with you. They look at that light. They look at that source of mercy and compassion. They look up to that. Life would not become dark in their eyes. Does not become dark. So, Imam al-Mahdi, don't forget him tonight. He's our leader. We have to pray for his reappearance. We have to say, Ya Hujjat Allah, we are waiting for you. We are prepared to you to be your least servants and soldiers, to protect you, to help you in your mission, the mission that has mentioned in all books, in all divine books. وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزَّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْدِ الذِّكْرِ. Allah says, we have written in all books, أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ يَرِثُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ, that the land, the leadership of this land is going to be inherited to those righteous, and the righteous is al-Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salatu wassalam and his companions. Allahumma kun li waliyyika al-Hujjah ibn al-Hasan salawatuka alayhi wa ala abaghih fi hadhihi as-sa'ati wa fi kulli sa'ah waliyan wa hafidha wa qa'idan wa nasira wa dalilan wa 'ayna hatta tuskinahu ardaka taw'a وتمتعه فيها طويلا. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين.